Well, for more on this jobs report, let's go now to Bloomberg Surveillance, where PIMCO's Bill Gross is speaking with Tom Keene and Ken Pruitt. Let's listen in.
Weakened in terms of their legitimacy because many of the structural jobs that we have lost, and they refer to automobile production that once was 16, 17 million units, and they refer to housing, which once was 2 million housing starts, and it refers to the old mortgage banking model and the old Wall Street model.
Right.
A lot of those jobs aren't coming back, and so the structural hole takes more than training and education to refill. And if that's what the remedy is, it'll take a long period of time.
Let's combine this jobs report with your research note the other day. You say a successful handoff from public to private credit creation has yet to be accomplished. If we're going to get this jobs number down under, say, 7%, we've got to have a banking industry there ready to loan, to lend, rather, and we got to have people that want that animal spirit loan. Do you see indications of a new animal spirit across America?
Well, the beginnings, Tom, the beginnings, you know, loans are picking up, some of those reserves that the Fed has so willingly provided to the system are being moved from the reserve column into the loan column. But yet, over a longer term basis, what you really see, the dominant trend has been a trend of globalization that allows corporations basically to invest their capital elsewhere. And if we want unemployment to come down here and job growth to go up, then it has to be a domestic animal spirit as opposed to a global animal spirit. And I suspect that because that's a long-term secular trend, that it'll be a long time coming before we get back to the level of 2007 and 2006, where the domestic economy was the economy of choice.
Bill, where are you in the discussion over whether the unemployment is structural or cyclical? In other words, whether the jobs will come back when the economy picks up or whether they just won't come back at all?
Well, we've talked about that considerably, Ken, over the past 6 to 12 months. And we didn't predate the Fed's discussion on Nehru, but, you know, it is really the critical argument. If we had a Nehru at 4 to 5% 3 or 4 years ago, where is it now? And you know, numerous Fed studies have basically been coming out suggesting anywhere to 6 to 7%, which means, in terms of structural loss, that we probably lost structurally maybe 2% of the labor force, and that it's not expected to come back, at least on a cyclical basis. So that's where we are, and I would expect the Fed, as we move lower from 9 to 8.9 this month, ultimately when it hits 7.5%, that's when the Fed begins to anticipate that we're moving closer to that 6.5% neighborhood.
How have you changed your investments at PIMCO, given oil at 103, NYMEX 116, Brent? Is there a new oil? Is there a new normal in oil for Bill Gross?
Well, if we stay at these levels, that's a geopolitical question, and probably better asked of Hillary Clinton than Bill Gross or Mohammed El-Aryan. But you know, to our way of thinking, at these levels at the moment, global growth slows by 0.5% to 1% more in Asian countries that are more dependent on oil as opposed to the United States. But in the United States, a quarter to 0.5% off GDP if we stay at these types of levels. Of course, if we accelerate by another 10 or 20 barrels, you have that effect and then some. So the growth slows down. The inflation, the headline inflation, goes up. Bernanke tends to think that doesn't matter, at least in terms of the headline versus the core. We do. We're very...
So, Bill, you would be more vigilant like Jean-Claude Trichet?
Oh, I think so.
As you were just hearing PIMCO's Bill Gross saying that he would be, in fact, watching inflationary pressures a bit more. Bill Gross of PIMCO.